Sex experts this morning. We've got Dr. Rose Hartzell as well as Dr. Goldstein from San Diego Sexual Medicine at Alvarado Hospital. They're answering all of your questions this morning when it comes to the bedroom. So if you have a little one in the room right now, we love to tell you this. We love to warn you ahead of time. Go ahead and shoo them out of the room. Maybe give them an activity, some crafts or something like that, because we're going to be talking about adult stuff. Thank y'all for being here, both of you.
Thank you.
We have a couple of viewer questions. Absolutely. Let's get right to our viewer questions. Our first one is kind of lengthy, but I think it's important. First question says, I've been married to my wife for 5 years. I've noticed a decrease in my sexual desire. I used to have a much higher desire for women that I dated before her. Is there any hope for me? What kinds of things might increase my desire? Dr. Goldstein, we'll start with you first.
Well, all of these questions will have a biopsychosocial component. So a man who has low desire should get a biologic evaluation. Say hormones could be mixed up. It could be that his erections are off, and that makes him have low interest. It could be that there are other medical issues, like a thyroid problem. So it has to be done together, but it needs to be done where each thing is done independently, and then a panel made of what is right and
Very
what is
good.
Wrong.
Dr. Hartzell, anything you want to add?
Yeah, this is a question I often hear a lot. And part of it is because sometimes men date people who they will lust after, and then they'll marry people they love. But you can have both. And one thing that I often recommend to these couples is to ask your partner for what you might want in the bedroom that you might have done with these other people. And you might be surprised. The person you love might be wanting a little more lust in the bedroom as well.
Sure, so, they might be willing and open to
explore. Don't be afraid to ask for that.
Very good. Okay, our next question. Lately, I've been feeling like my husband is more of a roommate than a romantic partner. I'm worried that we might be headed towards a sexless marriage. How can we get the passion back? We'll start with you, Rose.
The first thing I would ask that person to do is to get passion back into their own life. What things draw them to you or make them feel good? Is it art? Is it working out? First get your passion in your own life and then bring it to your partner. Another thing, which sounds counterintuitive, is to fight a little more. That can bring a little fire into a relationship that doesn't have any passion. And then
really, you recommend fight? So like picking a fight? What do you mean?
There's to a degree.
Okay.
Couples that avoid conflict at all costs can often have what I call a cold relationship. So if things are bothering you, you want to bring them up. Some conflict is good, and everything in balance or moderation can be good for a couple. And the last thing that I was just thinking of is maybe to do some things out of the ordinary. Do new and exciting things, get the heart rate up, to get the passion outside the bedroom together, and hopefully it will follow you
so
back
maybe
in the
like
bedroom.
Skydiving or something like that?
Exactly. Surprise,
okay.
Whatever.
Interesting, Dr. Goldstein.
It's basically the same answer. If she's on birth control pills, if she's on antidepressant agents, she's going to have low interest on a medical basis. So she can skydive all she wants. But if she doesn't have the basic biologic issues of testosterone and other hormones, she's going to have low interest. And she's going to blame the low interest on psychologic issues or
on him. Yeah.
So again, the sexual medicine issue is the biopsychosocial. Dr. Hartzell is awesome. We need to get some biologic effort, and then we can make things happen.
Interesting. Okay, I like this question because everybody's going out for Valentine's Day. They're cooking for Valentine's Day. So are there any foods or drinks that have been proven to increase libido? Dr. Goldstein, you're nodding your head.
So diet and exercise are very important. So foods that, like raw diet, or the one that we have the most information is Mediterranean diet. That's fruits, nuts, vegetables, olive oil, a little bit of wine. We have good data on that. Or a lot of wine. we have data on that. Exercise is very important. Get your adrenaline up. It's as Rose talked about.
Yeah, Rose, any other foods or drinks that you can think
of?
No,
but I know that you're cooking tonight with your husband.
So I'm cooking steak and potatoes. Is that good or no?
Have fun with that.
Okay. All right. Next, I like this question. This is from a viewer. A viewer wants to know, does size actually matter? Rose?
You know, I would actually be a big fat liar if I said size does not matter. So it does to a degree, but it depends on the partner. So for some women, it isn't as big. And what really matters the most over size is that your partner's a good listener in the bedroom, is that they listen to your physical and your vocal cues and
recommendations.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. Rose is 100% correct. The average is 5 to 6 inches, so you can go with that and find out someone well endowed may actually be a lousy person, and someone shorter may actually be a better person, and it's the whole package that's the key.
Doctors, thank you so much for being here. As always, we really appreciate it. Okay, now you can bring the kids back into the room if you want to. You can reach Dr. Goldstein and Dr. Hartzell at San Diego Sexual Medicine at Alvarado Hospital. All right, Raul, let's send it on back inside to you.
Okay, Erica Fox, thank you very much.